बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम, अस्सलाम वालेकुम माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स, इट्स मी योर इंग्लिश टीचर साइमा बशीर। वी ऑल आर पासिंग थ्रू अ टफ टाइम, बट बिलीव मी दिस टाइम विल पास टू। एज योर कॉलेज इज क्लोज्ड ड्यू टू दिस पैंडेमिक कोरोना वायरस, बट द प्रोसेस ऑफ एजुकेशन शुड नॉट बी स्टॉप्ड। एस AES हैज ट्राइड इट बेस्ट टू कीप इट गोइंग थ्रू इट्स यूनिवर्सिटी ऐप। Now it has taken one more step to introduce audio video lectures to make the students in touch with their studies. So gird up your lines and get ready to work very hard to show me your best. The introductory lecture, and I will introduce you with your subject syllabus and your paper format. So let's begin. In first year you have studied book 1 and book 3, but in second year you people are going to study book 2 and the novel Goodbye Mr. Chips. Book 2 that covered almost 1/3 part of your English paper is divided into two parts, that is modern prose that has 10 short essays in it, and the second part is heroes. It is about the personalities of the well-known people of the world. So in this way it has 15 lessons in it. This is a very important book, book 2. So here you will not be given any translation passage. Here you will be asked questions and you have to answer them. So the novel is Goodbye Mr. Chips that has 18 lessons in it, and we all need to cover it thoroughly. Now I will discuss with you the format of your English paper so that you can get a better understanding of your subject. English paper is divided into two parts, objective and subjective, and the total numbers of the paper are 100. Objective will be of 20 marks, and in objective paper you will be asked two questions. The question number one, in which you will be given options A, B, you will be given three portions A, B and C, and here you have to choose the right synonyms. So again this is taken from the part 1 and part 2, and then the four sentences will be taken from the novel Goodbye Mr. Chips. So in this way it will become question number 1 will be of 10 marks, and then there comes the question number 2. Here you have to fill in the blanks with appropriate preposition and it carries 5 marks. And then the last part of question number 2, that is choose the correct sentence. Here there will be an error, maybe of tense, maybe an article mistake, maybe prepositional mistake, maybe an adjective mistakes will be there, but you have to choose the right answers and it will be of 5 marks. So in this way your objective will be of 20 marks. Paper that is of 80 marks and it is divided into two sections. Section 1, that is of question number 3, that has 3 parts, A, B and C part, and it is mainly the section of question answer section. Here you have to answer the question, the questions that are taken from the book 2, from both the parts, and from both the parts, like in part 1, that is the part of 10 short essays, you will be given around about 8 questions from this part, and you have to answer the 6 questions, and it carries 12 marks. The same is revised with the part 2 from heroes sections. Again you will be given 8 questions and you have to answer the 6 question, and it is also portion of the 12 marks. Then there comes the novel Goodbye Mr. Chips. Here you will be asked 12 questions roundabout and you have to answer 8 questions, that carries 16 marks. Portion of 30 marks. Then there comes a section 2. In section 2 you will be again asked 3 questions. Question number 4, that will be a question of an essay. Here you will be given four topics and you have to choose the one to write an essay of 300 to 400 words on it, and it carries 15 marks. And then there comes your question number 5, that is the use of idioms. You will be given 8 idioms, and out of those 8 idioms you have to use the 5 idioms in your sentences. And remember, this is very much important because one idiom carries 2 marks. So in this way it is a question of 10 marks. Then there comes question number 6, that is a very important question. You were used to do that in your matric, but it is a bit different in this way. In matric you were given the scene passages and one is asked in your paper, but here in second year an unseen passage will be given to you and you have to translate that passage into English, and it carries 15 marks. So in this way you have to be very particular about this portion, because it is your grammar portion, and it is a portion of 40 marks. So to reach a destination, we always need a track to follow. Without a proper track, we cannot reach to our destination. So I am going to discuss with you the procedures, how will we go on. So I have divided your chapter into 3 parts. I will take 3 lectures. The lecture number 1, I will discuss the main points or summary of that lesson. In lecture number 2, we'll talk about the words and synonyms. I will take all the important words from your lessons, and I will write it down, the synonyms, and I will explain that too. In lecture number 3, that is a portion of the exercise. Here we will talk about, or we'll discuss the exercise, question answers, and other things related to your chapter. Then your lecture number 4, here I will do the idioms. I will introduce in first lecture what is idiom, and then I will give you 5 to 6 idioms in that lecture. In lecture number 5, we'll talk about the essay, or in lecture number 6, we'll talk about the paragraph translation, and then the procedure will go on, will follow the same. And again, we'll talk about the chapter number 2, and again we'll follow the same thing: main points, word synonym, exercise, and then we'll come to the idioms, essay, paragraph translation, and so on. So this is the procedure that we will follow. But to follow this procedure, I want all of you, what I require from you people, that you must have your books, your notebooks, and your pen with you while taking this online class. You need to write it down, all the important points, and I will also assign you homework, and I want you people to do that on a register, on a notebook. And when you will join the college again, when we shall meet again, I want to see that work. So hope so you people will cooperate, and you will get a great benefit from these online classes. So this is all for today, and so tomorrow I will start from lecture number 1, lesson number 1. So thank you so much, take care, have a good day, and all the best.